Hey, good morning, everybody. One more time, this is your boy Rob Thomas Jr., and this is the real news behind the news. The date and time is still the same from the last video that I just did. It's February 7, 2020. And I want to what I want to try to do is get people to think. Now, I'm going to show y'all how your pastors and religion is being used against you. In modern day time, I'm gonna basically go back to 1930s and use the name of Margaret Sanger. I bet three-fourths of the people on the planet, or three-fourths of the people that are gonna watch this video, don't even know who Margaret Sanger is, but she was the one who created Planned Parenthood. And Planned Parenthood is nothing more than a eugenicist. What's up, big kinfolk? What's going on? Good morning. Planned Parenthood is nothing more than a eugenicist project. When I say eugenicist, that means people who believe in population control. Margaret Sanger believed that black people were mentally inferior to white people and needed to be controlled as far as their population was concerned. Now, one way that Margaret Sanger said that this could be done is you got to take the black preacher. Put him in a suit, a nice pretty suit, and some shiny shoes, and put him out there in front of the black people and give him a controlled message. Now, what happened throughout slavery, the way that they kept us docile, the way that they kept us ignorant, was they used religion. And a lot of you Christians are going to get mad and disagree, but that's the truth is what it is. Notice this, they wouldn't let you read any books because they didn't want you to educate yourself. But every Sunday morning, they gathered all the slaves together and they read the Bible to them. If you go to prison right now and you're a Muslim or a member of any other religion, you got to file ARPs and all that to get your book in there. But the first book that they give you is a Bible, which teaches you in the New Testament how to be docile. Now, you got to understand, they have a thing called a clergy response team. And the clergy response team are those pastors who have a church of maybe over 200 to 300 members. They got a 501c3 status. So your government figure out a way to control them by threatening their 501c3 status. So what happens now is the government propaganda has pretty much superseded the mainstream media, and they put it into your churches. Why is it a lot of these black pastors are not speaking out against abortion, the killing of other human beings? You know why? Because if they did, it would threaten their 501c3 status. You have very few pastors that will speak out on inequality in a forceful manner. Look what happened with Jeremiah Wright. They got mad at Obama because he was going to Jeremiah Wright church. And Jeremiah Wright was the pastor that said, fuck America, fuck America's mama. Basically, that's what Jeremiah Wright said. And guess how hard in the paint they came against him. Nat Turner, Birth of a Nation, Michael Stanfield say, exactly. What you got to realize is they're using your pastors to keep you docile. Just think about it. Recently, we had a pastor here in Freeport who pretty much did the same thing that Gayle King did. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, that's a whole different subject. But they are using your pastors to promote government propaganda. Because if your pastor is getting 501c3 status, which means tax-free status, there's things that he can and cannot say. Because if he says the wrong thing, they're going to take his tax-free status away from him. So the objective, and it's always been this way with black people in America, is to use the Negro preacher to seduce and pacify and keep the black people docile, telling them that if master tells you something, obey without questioning him. If master hits you in your left cheek, you're supposed to turn and let him hit you in your right cheek. Let me ask y'all a question. Why do pastor and master sound just alike? Because master use your pastor to keep you docile. And this whether you white or black or not. You could be black, white, or whatever. If you subscribe to Christianity, you are being brainwashed. And I'm not indicting Christianity because I do believe in the one who was called Jesus. I do believe that he walked the earth. But Jesus was nothing like this docile individual that they would want you to believe. Why you think they killed him? They murdered him because he was a radical. He was actually telling the people, you don't need these hypocrite scribes and Pharisees to get close to God because you are a product of God and God is within you. But right now, they're using your pastors here to control the population. You see what I'm saying? To control what you hear. Think about it. Most Christians will not read any other book on history. Only book they're going to read is the Bible because pastor told them anything else outside the Bible is a sin and God is going to send you to hell. Why do they don't? Why? It's the same as slavery. They want to control the knowledge. When you ask a pastor, wait a minute. The dinosaur, if the world is only 6,000 years old, how can you go back and archaeologists are finding dinosaur bones and other fossils from a million years ago? They can't explain it. So they tell you, you're not supposed to ask those type of questions because only God has all knowledge. And some things are just not meant for man to understand. Wait a minute. I thought we was created in God's image, which means we have the ability to think. If they're finding these dinosaur bones, they're finding bones of Homo sapiens and Neanderthals that was a million years old, how the hell can the earth and mankind be only 6,000 years old? So it's exactly Wade Loveless, non-profits. If they speak out against the government propaganda, then you're going to lose your 501c status. Means you're not going to be tax-free anymore. So guess what preachers are going to do? To keep on building them big old shiny cathedrals, they're going to lie to you. They're going to go along with the government propaganda. Think about this. Why is it that we have more churches that are thriving in our neighborhoods than our public schools are thriving in our neighborhoods? You might have one public school per block, but on that block, you got three churches. They want these preachers to continue to deceive you. And the preachers who really want to stay getting paid have no choice but to go along with government propaganda. Again, black women, we abort per capita more of our children than anybody else. This was a design plan, but your preachers, especially your prominent black preachers, they're in favor of abortion, or they're not going to even speak out on it, because if they speak out against abortion, they are in jeopardy of losing their 501c3 status. To sum all this up, in short, your pastors are being used against you because they have to control, they have to keep putting out the government narrative. You know what I'm saying? As far as in their messages, they can't say anything that the government does not want them to say, or they will lose their 501c3 status. Let me ask you a question. If you was making $10,000 a month at your church, and you know if you say the wrong thing, that really is going to educate and empower people to take control of their lives and help overthrow this corrupt system. And if they knew they were going to lose, do you think they're going to preach that? No. They're going to keep telling you that Jesus say, slaves, obey your masters. When in reality, it's not natural for human beings to be slaves. Man, it's crazy. Hey, I just put this out there. I did this video because I'm going to upload it to YouTube. But I thought you all should know. Because again, you look at what's going on here in Shreveport. Let me show you something. You got, my hood, the Cooper Road. Man, do you realize you got over 35 churches on the Cooper Road? But it is one of the most impoverished areas in the city. But when you go up there, you look at some of them churches, just one church, and I hate to call name, but I'm going to call it because I have to. Just look at Lake Bethlehem. Lake Bethlehem by itself is almost worth then one third, is worth more than one third of the properties up there on the Cooper Road. Why is that? Straight up, man. They're using these pastors to control what it is that you hear, see, and how you think. And these pastors are mandated by the government. Go and research what a clergy response team is. Do y'all realize that that clergy response team is a branch of the FEMA? Is a branch of FEMA. And what they're doing, again, they're using your pastors against you to control the narrative and knowledge. Why you think when the politicians get ready to run for office, you never see them in your neighborhood? But the year that they're running for mayor, for city council, for government, what the first place they come? To your church. You never see them until it's time for them to get elected. And then the first place that they're going to go is to the black church. They call that putting a roof on the church, because they're going to give your pastor so much money to let him come in there and continue to spit the propaganda. You got to understand game, y'all.